Should women grow their facial hair too? Teddy Locsin Jr. shares his thoughts on that in tonight's Teditorial.
November is Facial Hair Month. Men are encouraged to let the hair grow on their faces. The idea is to draw awareness to prostate cancer, or cancer in the male organ from lack of use. Whatever the connection between facial hair and prostate cancer, feminists jumped on the facial hair bandwagon, asking, when did it become a rule that women should not have facial hair? The answer is, it was never a rule that women should not have facial hair. It was just a taste. No man wants to romance a woman who looks like a man, and no woman wants to romance a man who thinks she is. But why jump on someone else's bandwagon to fight a sickness unique to men in order to advance a cause unique to women? Men do not go braless to demand the courtesy that women get of having their chairs pulled out for them at dinner. To each his own. Italians love women with mustaches, but only if they are grandmothers who cook well. Personally, I favor women joining in. For one, men get prostate cancer because they are not getting enough of it from women. So maybe joining Facial Hair Month may alert women to how they are failing in that respect. For another, at least once a year in November, men should know which women can grow beards, so that they will know who of their possible spouses will look like them. Keep well.